I'm Chris Malaisrie. I'm a cardiac surgeon at Northwestern Memorial Hospital and professor of surgery at Northwestern University. The Ross procedure is a surgical procedure that we do for patients with aortic valve disease who need an aortic valve replacement. Experience with the Ross procedure is very important because it's a complex surgical operation. The surgeon needs to be experienced with root and valve surgery. We're happy to report that at Northwestern and Lurie Children's Hospital, we've done the most Ross procedures in the state of Illinois with 100% survival in hospital. Most patients with aortic valve disease are older and they can get an artificial biologic valve, which is totally fine for patients who are older, 70 years old. This is the vast majority of patients that we see. But there is a smaller subgroup of patients, younger patients, like less than 50 years of age, who have valves that cannot be repaired. So they're facing aortic valve replacement. I think the Ross procedure is perfectly positioned for a patient like this. We think that less than 1,000 cases are done per year, but we think that it's an underutilized operation. In this case, we take the patient's own pulmonary valve and translocate it into the aortic position. We take a human pulmonary valve to take the place of the old pulmonary valve. I think the single most compelling factor with the Ross procedure is that the patient gets a living valve in the aortic position. This was designed by a surgeon named Donald Ross from the United Kingdom, and he accurately predicted that if you take the patient's own pulmonary valve and use it as a replacement in the aortic position, that the valve is actually living. That confers several advantages. One of them is restoration of normal life expectancy. Second is the valve can heal and adapt by itself. So the patient's pulmonary valve goes in the aortic position, it will adapt to the systemic pressure and become a valve that is perfectly positioned for aortic valve replacement. And in addition, it can heal itself and be resistant to infection. So we find that patients are resistant to infective endocarditis. One limitation of the Ross procedure is that we need a pulmonary homograft. The homograft is a pulmonary valve and root that's taken from another human being, a cadaver. They're cryopreserved, so they're put on ice. Sometimes they're decellularized. They have a shelf life expectancy of about 10 years, but they're quite expensive and they're rare commodities to get. The Ross procedure has very good durability, but some patients can experience failure. And there's two modes of failure. The autograft, which is the patient's own pulmonary valve, can fail, and the homograft, which is the cadaveric pulmonary valve, can also fail. Of the two, we see that the autograft can dilate over time, and that is the most common mode of failure, and even then, it's not very common. We estimate there to be about a 1 to 1.5% per year risk of reoperation of the pulmonary autograft. For the pulmonary homograft, some centers have reported less than 5% failure rate out to 20 years. An important aspect of the Ross procedure is post-operative care. And one of the things we look for after the Ross procedure is to allow the autograft to adapt over time. The autograft is seeing now systemic pressure, whereas previously seeing pulmonary pressure. So blood pressure control after the Ross is really important. We're targeting a systolic blood pressure of 115 millimeters of mercury or less.